Trey Gowdy never shies away from a fight, especially when American freedom and liberty is at stake. A longtime favorite of President Trump, Trey Gowdy continues to demand answers to questions the media refuses to ask. So Trey took his message directly to the American people when he appeared on CBS Sunday program, Face the Nation. Trey Gowdy told Face the Nation host John Dickerson Sunday that he's disappointed that Democrats aren't more outraged over the unmasking of private citizens by the intelligence community. Trey acknowledges the need to get to investigate Russia's interference in the 2016 election, but as we do, we would be wise not to fall into the bigger trap, allow our freedoms and laws to be eroded. Whether a witch hunt or legitimate, protecting our laws and freedoms is at the heart of the investigation. And that means whether the threat comes from Vladimir Putin or disgruntled employees of the U.S. government. The incidental collection of U.S. persons happens, the South Carolina Republican stated. What I wish some of my friends on the other side would be a little more outraged about is the political use of that unmasking. I understand we collect U.S. citizens, he continued. But we don't read about those U.S. citizens on the front page of the New York Times and the Washington Post. Gowdy went on, that, in addition to threatening these surveillance programs, is also a felony. All of this is important, John, every bit of it, Gowdy added. The felonious dissemination of classified information is the only thing we know for sure is a crime, and it would be nice if we showed the same level of interest in that. And that is where the liberals get lost in the weeds. Let's investigate the Russia connection, but let us not forget about the crimes already committed. It would be a cruel irony that in order to protect ourselves from authoritative regimes like Putin's, we would violate the laws put in place that actually protect the state from abusing its power. Envolve helped contribute to this report. It's News Exposed signing off.